Martin Fayulu says he has evidence to prove he won last month's election by a landslide 61% of the vote. And the presidential runner-up is challenging the result in the Constitutional Court.
I'm hoping that the Constitutional Court will call the Electoral Commission to recount the ballot papers, because that's what the law said. We totally disagree with the result that CENI has announced. They are false, they are fabricated, they have nothing to do with the truth.
Provisional results released by the Election Commission on Thursday declared Felix Tshisekedi the winner with nearly 39% of the vote. His supporters say Fayulu should accept the result.
I'm calling on him. I'm calling on my colleague more than say, guys, stop it. It's time. We want it. We didn't cheat it. We didn't make an arrangement, special arrangement. This is just the result of the polling station. And we may show what our proof, because we do have it. We don't want to go into a fight.
Unlike previous elections, voting day at the end of last month was relatively peaceful. But growing suspicions over the count could derail Congo's first democratic transfer of power since independence from Belgium in 1960.
Constitutional Court judges are due to meet on Monday and Tuesday to go through what Martin Fayulu says is evidence which proves he won last month's election. If the judges say he has no case, then Felix Tshisekedi will be sworn in as president.
The influential Catholic Church is rejecting the official result. So too is France and former colonial power, Belgium. The African Union and the Southern African Development Community Regional Body are appealing to the people of Congo to respect the eventual decision of the Constitutional Court judges and avoid a violent reaction. Haru, Mutasa, Al Jazeera, Kinshasa.